time to get that transition right. All right, guys, how's it going there today? Charlie Davis Live. I'm here, guys, getting a little workout in. I want to chat with you a little bit today. You know, a lot of people like that karate video I did, fight I did 37 years ago, right? And it was in the Battle of Atlanta, which was one of the largest karate tournaments in the country at the time. And it was really, really pretty cool. 150 black belts and all, and made it to the top. A lot of people seem to like that old school stuff. But I want to talk to you a little bit about today, about the way I won it. Not just that, but right after that, I think I won about 6 grand championships in karate back to back before Marty Knight, who a lot of you guys know, actually beat me in the tournament, and I broke my streak. But I was really pretty aggressive, as you might see, but I was doing kickboxing for the most part in a karate type format. And I want to show you a little bit of a few techniques for you guys who still might practice karate and want to advance in karate tournaments. I'm going to tell you how to do that, because a lot of those techniques are similar. They're kind of the same, but you just have to transition a little bit different. And if you train like a kickboxer, which a lot of karate guys trying to figure out, that's why I developed the point kickboxing, the point Muay Thai, because of what it is, and you can see how big it is today, and that is why. But if you train like a kickboxer and you are a karate guy, I'm telling you, you will be in better shape. It's just reality. For the most part, right? Depends on the individual. But for the most part, you'll be in better shape because of the repetition of what you can do. Now, the key is that ideally speaking, you don't supposed to be throwing jabs, crosses, and hooks in karate. Ideally speaking, you don't. But what I figured out many, many years ago was that because I was a kickboxer, that I could train a certain kind of way and just change it just a little bit when I fought. And that is why, for some of you guys who saw that Battle of Atlanta clip, over 100 and some of you people saw it, at least liked it, over 500 or 600 people saw it, that it was me fighting kickboxing in a karate tournament. So I want to explain that to you just a little bit of what that is. And actually, to be honest with you, I actually have a seminars that I do that helps people who are in karate and other taekwondo and other martial arts convert, if they will, or at least add the kickboxing to your regimen or to your techniques. All right, it's great for trainers. So if anybody interested in seminars like that, just let me know. All right, so the first thing is the jab, right? In kickboxing, you know, the jab is like, right? Basic jab. But you have a back fist. Back fist is still off the front hand. The back fist goes more around like this in karate. So it's like this. So what I would do, right? I would take the jab, throw the jab, pop him in the face, and bring it back like a back fist. Now, how can you tell the difference? You can't tell the difference, right? So I would just go like, boom, you know, in the point karate, same thing. With the reverse punch, like in karate, the reverse punch is this, like, like underneath, which I landed a couple, they call it. Underneath, all that is a cross, right? So if you're trying to have like a cross, in the kickboxing, all you have to do in the point karate, just go under, right? It's just the same thing, but the difference is the conditioning level, because you're right? That it just gets you in better shape. All you got to do is click your mind. You click your mind, right? Then you're going to have a great reverse punch. Same thing with the ridge hand. Ridge hand is what? A hook. Bap. Just a hook punch. Hook punch. Push. That's my hook. All I would do in the tournament, instead of throwing the hook here, I'm just turning it over like that. Hit with that palm part of my hand right there, and I would turn it over to a ridge hand. So it's the same conditioning. Ridge hand. Hook. Ridge hand. Hook. Same thing. Uppercuts is also like that underhand. If you're doing that same kind of thing. Anyway, my point is, it's not one that's so much better than the other. I'm telling you from my own experience, right, that I was in better shape than most people I fought. That's why I won a lot, right? And it was the way I trained with those techniques, that repetitive, that fast, quick, moving a lot, all of that. And if you saw in that one video, I kicked like, I don't know, like crazy, because I was in better shape. I wasn't just trying to land one technique and stop. I kept going. I was in shape so I could throw everything, all of my arsenal. I did spinning kicks, spin back kicks, jabs, cross, spinning, everything. I did everything. But that's because in full contact kickboxing at the time, or even today in Muay Thai, that's the way you train with everything. So you want to open up your arsenal so that you can be diverse in your training. You can pick a style over the other, but adding all that together can make you a very, very good fighter. All right, guys. All right, so listen, I just wanted to go over that with you. The other thing is I want to chat with you a little bit about was the East Coast Classic. Next weekend, baby! It's almost here! 1 week away. Most of the fighters are staying in really strong. Gonna have a great, great weekend, guys, of action starting on Friday night. That's where the fights start, but we're gonna be there from early weigh-ins on Thursday. Friday night, next Friday, the fights start from 6 to 11. Saturday morning, 9 to 5. Saturday night, 6 to 11. And Sunday from 9 to 5, boy, we got a packed schedule, like 120-some fights over the weekend. It's going to be absolutely outstanding. It's going to be one of the best shows in the I'm going to say in the United States, okay? I'm going to go that far. So listen, I need you to ask your friends and family to get those tickets now at akpromotions.org. Come out and support the sport, guys. There's a lot of martial artists of all kinds out there. We're going to have some great fights. We're going to have a lot of lights. We're going to have food. We're going to have cameras. It's going to be a great Las Vegas weekend on the Grand Strand, baby, the IKF East Coast Classic, March the 19th through the 21st. Listen, I don't know where you, if you're anywhere within 2 or 3 hours, you need to make a field trip out of that. Go on the calendar, look at what's going on, and I'm telling you right now, it's going to be awesome. Marty, who's that? Morales. Right, Rudy Morales. It's going to be March 19th. Through the 21st in Myrtle Beach at the Landmark Resort right there in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. I'm telling you right now, it's not going to be in Las Vegas. It's going to be like Las Vegas, though. You know, we do it all in one ring. It's a lot of fighting going on. Men, women, and juniors, they're fighting for nice championship belts and cups and all of that. Right? AKPromotions.org, Mr. Morales, if you want to see more on the event. It's going to be outstanding. Got a lot of fighters. We have 3 United States title fights that weekend. Come on now. Just that alone is worth the ticket, right? On each one of those shows, you got 25 fights, 25, 45 on Saturday, something like that. Crazy! It's going to be great. It's going to be fun. I want to thank all of my officials and everything for helping me out for this event coming up. I appreciate all of you. Respect all of you. Thanks so much. But I need all you fighters on the show, right? Speaking of being on the show, I got Johnny Davis Live coming up this Saturday. I want some of you guys to come on. If you're going to be on the show, right, if you're going to be in the tournament next week, come on the show this Friday. Give me a call. Send me a messenger. Give me a call. All my information is out there. Say, hey, I want to come on. I got a story to tell. I overcome something. I had this or I had that or you know, this and that, you know, whatever. Or I'm just so excited to be there because maybe I heard about the event and I want to be a part of it. Whatever the reason is, right, Come on the show. Let's talk about kickboxing. Let's talk about Muay Thai. Let's talk about the IKF East Coast Classic next weekend. It's going to be phenomenal. Last but not least, a lot of you saw where I got my COVID vaccine, my first one, with Pfizer vaccine. And I want to tell you the truth about what happened on the process. First of all, get your vaccine if you can. We got to get a 70% immunity thing. You either want to be a part of the solution or the problem. Well, that's the way I look at it. I want to be a part of the solution. I got my vaccine, my first one. I'm going to get my second one. Now, here's what happens. You get a shot in the arm, and you don't even hardly feel it. You don't even hardly feel it, right? Now, the next day, it's like somebody put a nail up and put it with a hammer. It hurts the next day. It does. You don't feel that thing the first day. Then the second day, oh, my God, you feel it, right? Yeah, it's just your arm, right? So, me being crazy, I jumped out there the next day and tried to work out. Well, there wasn't nothing but kicks that day because I didn't have a left arm, right? You know, right? So it was good. And the thing about it is that it did hurt. Then I think I felt a little lethargic maybe. Yesterday, I think I did a little bit, because I said, you kind of know yourself. I said, I think I feel a little down. So I didn't work out yesterday. But today, I feel, you can see, I'm back 100% normal. And I feel that I've done the right thing right? And protecting those people around me. I'm around tens of thousands of people every year, and I think I've done the right thing. So anyway, if you can, if you like, please get your vaccine, guys. Just get this COVID. It's going away. We're defeating it. It's going to be all said and done. All right, guys, that's all I have for you right now. For you karate guys out there, again, that's the way you want to improve your technique. Try some kickboxing. It really works, guys. All right, guys, everybody, wear that mask for right now. Forward march, Johnny Davis Live. I'm checking out. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.